to share some additional details about my Milana ponytail wig, because I've had a few people ask me specifically about the wefting and whether or not I have experienced an issue with the wefting being visible while I'm wearing this particular wig. So I figured this video might be helpful to share my experience with the wefting, and I'm also going to show you close up like what the wefting would look like in certain styles or situations, and things to keep in mind if you're looking into this wig. So I will say that I wear this wig probably mostly either down or in a half up ponytail style, and I haven't experienced any issues with the wefting showing, but I did realize that when I'm trying to put it up in a half up ponytail, I do have to be more mindful of how much hair I'm leaving down in order to cover up the wefting. So because this wig is lower density and it has a wefted cap, there are times where the wefting can be more visible depending on how you're styling it and whether or not it's a super windy day. So here she is in a half up ponytail style, and I literally just like quickly pulled it back, so please ignore the messiness of the half up pony. But so when it's up in a half ponytail, you know, if you gathered too much hair up top and there wasn't enough hair left down, then it definitely can show through, you know, the wefting. And then also, like, you know, if it was super windy, well, let me just show you first off, like, if it's in the style and there's enough hair that's down, you can't see the wefting. But because there's less hair covering the wefts, if the wind were to blow or the hair got moved in any way, then yes, the wefting is much more visible in that type of situation in this particular style. You can see the wefting pretty easily there. But you know, like I said, I wear it in a half up pony all the time, and I don't have any like issues with it becoming visible. I mean, if the wind blows, it's just, you know, typically like, you know, something like that. It doesn't just like directly, you know, go through and show the wefted cap area. And it definitely doesn't like stay like that long enough for anybody to notice. But if that's something that's really gonna bother you, then this wig might not be the best choice for you, because it does have less hair covering up the wefted cap. So just something to keep in mind. You know, here's some of the back, same thing, like if the wind blew and the hair got spread enough, then you would see some of the wefting. Some people have also asked me, like, do I have any issues with the wefting showing while I'm wearing it down? And I haven't had any issue. I wear this wig down a lot as well. I mean, the wefting is definitely not, you know, just visible as is. It's only going to become visible if, like, it's super windy and the hair like gets moved a lot, then you might see some of the wefting. So there's some wefting there. But I mean, all that hair would have to get moved. I'm just trying to give y'all different examples of the movement of the hair and what it would look like and how visible the wefting is. So, like I said, I haven't really experienced any issues with the wefting, but I will say that because of the lower density, there's more of a chance, depending on how much the hair is moved and spread across, there's more of a chance of the wefting becoming visible. So if that's something that turns you off or is a big con for you, then maybe this isn't the best choice wig. But I'm very happy with this wig. I like the lower density. It's much easier for me to put this wig up in a half style, half ponytail style, or in a full ponytail style, and I love the way it looks while it's down also. So, I prefer lower density wigs. So, it just comes down to what is your preference and whether or not having the wefted cap with this lower density wig would really be bothersome for you with possible chances that the wefting may become visible. And I think that like this particular wig, I would absolutely love in a hand tied version. I don't know if they have a hand tied version available. I didn't see that as an option, but I think that that definitely would solve that issue with the wefting being visible. With it being lower density, I definitely think the hand tied would be awesome in this particular wig. But there you have it. I hope that showing you more closely and kind of, being specific about the wefting and showing you examples of, how the hair moves and whether or not the wefting becomes visible has answered those questions that you may have had about the wefting. Please let me know if you have any other questions about this particular wig. I'm happy to share my experience and, answer any other questions you may have. Thanks for listening and watching. I hope you guys have a great day. Bye, everybody.